Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. I'm gonna make it stop, make it stop, make it stop. we can go close to the Vyasas and closer to Prabhupada. Let's move on.
Thank you. Thank you. Krishna 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 Prabhupada, you do have a chance to handwrite an offering
And there are sheets available for that, hopefully pens as well, so I'm informed. So that is what we're going to do now, even while the RD is going on, for the lordships. I would suggest people who come to a little tight, you know? We're one family, you know? Instead of being so loving and personal. Just come close together. And come close together. It's a good feeling. Okay? And after the reading, then we are going to have prasad. Okay? And that will be in this room. We'll sit over. So the I hope we're all almost settled down right now. Something else we do is contributed by Chaitanya Charan Das, associate editor of Back to God magazine, Shastra Advisory Council member. Okay? So I hope it won't be too late for you. This is one exception. Here we are. This is with our chance to hear the philosophy. Expression reflects and reinforces emotion. The celebration of Vyasa puja is an expression of the gratitude that the disciple feels for the spiritual master. And that feeling becomes reinforced when a disciple expresses his own gratitude and hears other disciples express theirs. The spiritual master's guidance and grace are indispensable for elevating and liberating souls caught in this treacherous material existence. The spiritual master is not different from the Supreme Personality of Godhead, as the sacred scriptures proclaim. At Srimad Bhagavatam 11:17:27, in the Urdhva Gita, Krishna himself declares that the Acharya is non-different from him, Acharya non-vijaniyam. This non-difference is not because of a merging of beings, but because of the joining of hearts. The spiritual master is pure and selflessly surrendered to Krishna, as was Arjuna at the end of the Bhagavad Gita, 1873. The spiritual master is not just the conveyor of Krishna's will, he is also the gateway to Krishna on Krishna's behalf. He receives the disciple's service and bestows mercy. Yasha prasada, Bhagavad prasada, Yasha prasada, only by the mercy of the spiritual master is the mercy of Krishna accessed. So potent and transformational is the spiritual master's mercy that the sincere disciple feels and remains indebted lifetime after
lifetime.
The disciple strives to express that gratitude by dedicating his life to the spiritual master's service. During the course of our life, Vyasa Puja offers us a precious annual opportunity to meditate on and better appreciate our spiritual master's gifts. In composing our offering to the spiritual master, we go deep into our heart, going beyond the routines and superficialities that frequently crowd our consciousness. We focus on that which matters most, the supreme treasure like Krishna Bhakti, with which the spiritual master has enriched our heart. And by hearing the offerings of other devotees, we see those devotees with great appreciation, not just for their functional roles in this world, but also as devoted and exalted souls committed to the spiritual master's service. Leading a life of devotion givers of devotion lessens the difficulty. A child may be reluctant to take a bitter medicine, but if he remembers that his mother has sold her jewelry to pay for that medicine, then contemplating her sacrifice will replace reluctance with gratitude. It's for gift. Similarly, difficulties while practicing and sharing Krishna Bhakti may make us reluctant in our service, but by meditating on the innumerable and insurmountable sacrifices Srila Prabhupada made just to give us the opportunity to practice Bhakti, we can shed our reluctance and face wholeheartedly whatever challenges confront us. If we keep the memories of his sacrifices alive in our hearts, he will come deeper into our hearts. The glory of his gifts will be increasingly revealed to us, and he will conquer our hearts more and more. Srila Prabhupada conquered by surrendering on the Jaladutta boat. In his celebrated song, Markine Pavadharma, he prayed to Krishna, "O Lord, I am just like a puppet in your hands. So if you brought me here to dance, then make me dance. Make me dance. O Lord, make me dance as you like." On the sacred occasion of Srila Prabhupada's Vyasa puja celebration, during ISKCON's 50th year, we pray that we too may surrender so that we can dance like puppets in Srila Prabhupada's hands and do our small parts to push on his glorious mission. Hare Krishna.
Jai.
Srila Prabhupada ki.
Jai.
Jai. And so that was the offering by one devotee on the meaning of Vyasa Puja. And now, what I think we can do is have someone read the offering from Nurimana Dham. It suggested that we read our offering first. Some will break. As each year passes by, it gets more difficult to offer basins. Okay, this is dear Srila Prabhupada, Namo Om Vishnu Padaya, Krishna Prashtaya, Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swami Dhanamani, Namaste Saraswati Devi, Gauravani Prachayini, Dear Nishimishu Shunyavani, Paschatya Vishakayini. On a recent 45-day pilgrimage through the Northeast United States, I had much time to contemplate. It was a walk to express my utter appreciation to you. With 1,500 kilometers, 932 miles under my feet. Formerly, the trek was dubbed walking for our teachers. My route took me from Boston's Commonwealth Pier, where he first landed in America 51 years ago, to Butler, Pennsylvania, where he spent a good month, and then to New York City, where he began your mission. It's not officially incorporating it in July 1966. The society you initiated was a major milestone. The ISKCON Vaishnava culture took hold, but not without trials and tribulations. Like a trekker walking the Pennsylvania mountain valley terrain over the last five decades, ISKCON has climbed and descended quite a few steep slopes. In your endeavor to cement ISKCON within the modern world. You worked to make it a recognizable force, grounded in culture and education, rather than merely another religion added to an already pluralistic world of faith. We shall now see how effectively we can continue to market the prime entity, Krishna, and mold your marvelous society over the next 50 years. There is much work to be done. If I may, I would like to present to you and to the Society of Devotees my humble analysis of some of your contributions to the world and what makes you unique. And subtitled, The Cutting Edge Guru. Number one, you pioneered the practice of kirtan in the West with emphasis on the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Krishna Krishna. Hare Hare. Hare Rama. Hare Rama. Rama Rama. Hare Hare.
Number two, you introduced to the West the culture of Bhakti Yoga, an ancient devotional lifestyle with emphasis on serving the supreme deity, Krishna. Number three, you wrote and published books and articles and established the Bhaktivedanta Book Trust, BBT, presenting a scholarly Vedic library of writings on Eastern thought. Number four, you established a worldwide spiritual mission registered as the International Society for Krishna Consciousness, ISKCON. Number five, you became a strong and early voice promoting animal rights, especially the protection of the cow and the bull. Number six, you strongly promoted a non-violent vegetarian way of life and were perhaps the first teacher of Vedic cooking in the West. Number seven, you introduced to the West the Vedic consecration of food as prasadam. Number eight, you promoted a God-centered agrarian culture, a back-to-the-land initiative centered on a family farm and an eco-friendly existence. Number nine, you initiated the world's first large-scale program of sanctified vegetarian food distribution to the needy in Mayapur. Number 11, you strongly spoke up against drug and alcohol consumption as harmful. Number 11, you boldly promoted the science of the soul's transmigration, reincarnation. Number 12, you strongly challenged atheism and Darwin's theory of evolution and constantly promoted the principle that there is a God and that he is a person. Number 13, you introduced to the West the ancient techniques of archana or puja, honoring the divine in his sacred image. Number 14, you promoted the anti-racist sentiment by propagating the all-inclusive philosophy that all souls are equal and that we are not these bodies. Number 15, you redefined the word party. Sing the holy names, dance, play music, eat karma-free food, no intoxication, no lewdness, serve each other. Also, your divine grace was a major positive influence on history's most popular rock band, the Beatles, especially on George Harrison, who impacted a generation, if not more. For all of the above, I offer you the utmost reverence and gratitude, begging to remain your humble servant. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Bhakti Yoga Guru, can you read it for us?
Yeah.
While Prabhu is just coming forward, many devotees have picked up their papers to write their offerings. So please take your time and write them. Don't rush it. It's meant to be something very personal. Whenever you're ready, you can drop it in the box, and we'll add it to the book. So if you have one of the papers, you can write your offering. Even by the end of the program today, we'll make sure it gets added to our ISKCON Toronto book, which will be offered shortly. And then also, if anybody does not know what I'm talking about, just pick up the offering paper, and then you can drop it in the box. So this is Prabhupada Krishna Maharaj's recipe offering.
Dear Srila Prabhupada, I beg to offer you my most respectful obeisances at your divine lotus feet this year as we are going to celebrate your 120th birth anniversary. First, I want to apologize for not having submitted my Vyasa puja offering in time last year. I also admit that I am most unqualified to describe your unlimited transcendental glories and achievements. On August 13, 2015, we celebrate the golden jubilee of your Jagaduta Yatra. Your Kolkata temple organized a major celebration on this auspicious occasion. You struggled in India before starting your journey to America. You agreed to travel on a cargo ship. You experienced sickness, dizziness, headache, vomiting, and lack of appetite during your 35-day sea voyage. You even suffered two heart attacks. After your second heart attack, you thought that your mission might not be successful. But Lord Krishna appeared to you in a dream in which he was guiding the boat. He assured you there was nothing to fear and you should go ahead with your mission. This year, we are celebrating the golden jubilee of your incorporating ISKCON as a legal society and opening your first ISKCON temple in New York. A friend suggested that you call your society the International Society for God Consciousness, but you insisted that the word God was vague, whereas Krishna was exact and scientific. 2 months ago, we had a big celebration in Mumbai, in which several ISKCON leaders, many temple devotees, and thousands of congregational devotees participated. During the last week of May, we are going to have a big festival in Delhi, in which important political dignitaries and over 3,000 devotees will participate. Srila Prabhupada, you offer the entire world a way to live peacefully by uniting under the banner of Krishna consciousness. Your transcendental fame is increasing every day as your movement continues to spread all over the world. More people are taking to Krishna consciousness because of the enthusiasm of your devotees and potency of the body, of the holy name, of your holy name and your books. Your books are transcendental weapons that cut through all the layers of ignorance and false ego. Recently, I had the privilege of presenting to the Indian Prime Minister the deluxe edition of your Bhagavad Gita as it is, produced by Madhusevita Prabhu. The Prime Minister appreciated the Gita very much and was pleased to hear that it has been translated into more than 70 languages. On several occasions, he mentioned that ISKCON was doing good work. Srila Prabhupada, you are the real inspiration behind all our activities, preaching, book distribution, temple construction, prasadam distribution, farm development, etc. History will recognize you as the savior of humanity. On this most auspicious day, I fall at your lotus feet and beg for forgiveness for my countless offenses. Please continue to engage me in your ISKCON society, birth after birth. Your insignificant servant, Prabhupada Krishna Goswami.
Srila Prabhupada, thank you very much. And now the offering will be read on behalf of the new Raguna team, management team, consisting of Karna Sindhu,
Kevala Bhakti, Satyabhama, and Rukmini, Dasas and Devi Dasis. This is our marvelous team who are behind so many beautiful things that happen in our temple here, such as the festival of Janmashtami that we had just yesterday. And we'd like to take a moment to recognize them and applaud them for their hard work. They put in so many hours, and it's remarkable what they do. Professional, sensitive, full of bhakti, overflowing with honey. We're going to, we'll get up there sometime in the future. I assure you that you will be a leader in ISKCON.
Dear Srila Prabhupada, please accept our humble obeisances at your lotus feet. Nama Om Shivaya Krishna Prashaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Nityananda Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Vacharini Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Vashya Foundation. Srila Prabhupada, we often hear about the amazing fact that by your mercy, devotees are worshipping Lord Krishna all around the world. Here in Toronto, we are very blessed to have very fertile spiritual soil. It seems that there are countless people who are ready for Krishna consciousness. However, what if we traveled far from Toronto? In fact, what if we traveled so far that we found ourselves in Amman, Jordan, in the Middle East? Srila Prabhupada, we have an amazing story about how your mercy is manifested in an extraordinary way. A few years back, a very nice lady was regularly attending our monthly yoga outreach programs at the temple called the Evening of Bhakti. This nice lady's name is Rula. Originally from Amman, Jordan, she had been living in Canada for a few years. She would regularly attend the monthly kirtans and love chanting Hare Krishna. Then, she had to move back to Jordan. She stayed in touch with the devotees in Toronto, began teaching yoga classes in the Middle East, and developed a desire to start holding kirtans as well. The Toronto devotees gave her a few pointers, but we were unable to do much more than that. However, she came across devotees in Dubai. After explaining her spiritual path, an amazing devotee from Dubai invited her to stay with him and his family, and offered to continue to train her in the process of kirtan. Rula is now holding regular kirtans, chanting Hare Krishna beads, and sharing the holy names in the heart of the Middle East. How is this possible, Srila Prabhupada? We didn't contact or coordinate with the devotees in Dubai, and they didn't contact us. Yet, the shared vision of executing your desire to give Krishna consciousness to anyone and everyone inspired devotees who were oceans apart to cooperate, even unknowingly. Srila Prabhupada, the community of devotees at New Raghunadham would like to collectively offer all of our devotion and efforts this year to your lotus-like feet. This past year has been filled with opportunities seized, challenges faced, struggles experienced, and celebrations shared. This year being the one in which we observe the 50th anniversary of your incorporating ISKCON, we have a momentous opportunity to celebrate the growth and development of your international movement. Celebrations are taking place in every corner of the globe and right here in Canada as well. As an offering to you, Srila Prabhupada, we submit all the hard work rendered by devotees doing incredible outreach at ISKCON Toronto. Devotees are sharing your message of peace and goodwill through university outreach, a fledgling restaurant, dynamic food fairs, interfaith initiatives, our Rath Yatra festival, school visits, food for life, talks at temples, yoga programs, and more. The Toronto Sankirtan team continues to set wonderfully ambitious goals for distributing your books throughout the greater Toronto area and beyond. Like a transcendental snowball, the enthusiasm exponentially grows among devotees as they continually inspire one another with Sankirtan efforts and stories that result in an avalanche of increasing book scores. The ongoing cultivation and growth of our devotee community can be seen through home programs, bhakti rikshas, Sunday feasts, mentorship, grand festivals, Vaishnava care, guidance from visiting and local senior devotees, and of course, the loving, strong bonds that are forming among the members of the Toronto devotee community. Like feeble toddlers just learning to walk, we humbly present all these initiatives as a small offering to you on the occasion of your Vyasa puja. We thank you for all you have given us here in Toronto and around the world. It is by your divine mercy that the chanting of Hare Krishna resounds from Toronto, Canada to Amman, Jordan, and beyond. We remain eternally indebted to you and humbly fall at your lotus feet. Hare Krishna, your insignificant servants at New River Madan, ISKCON Toronto, Canada.
Srimad Bhaktivedanta Swami Ki Namaste, Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pracharya Nirvisesha Sunyavani Prasatati Sitami. Dear Srila Prabhupada, as we celebrate the 50th anniversary of ISKCON, we must recognize the explosion of Sankirtan. Because you boldly boarded the Jaladuta, you transformed the world from Africa to America. Because you heeded your Guru Maharaj's instruction, so many temples, including the TOVP, are under construction. Because you left your beloved Vrindavan, you provided our souls a chance at true freedom. Srila Prabhupada, you are the most perfect devotee, following the instructions of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. O Lord, make me dance as you like, was your humble request. And with that for Lord Krishna, your heart and soul, you would invest. You were resolute in your mission, but your efforts were not for your personal ambition. Srila Prabhupada, you have given us everything we need, planting in us the bhakti lata seed. You are forever our well-wisher. You are our perfect spiritual master. You plucked us from the clutches of Maya. You are ISKCON's founder Acharya. Through your teachings of Vedic philosophy, you changed the course of history. You desire to rescue all without giving heed to a person's caste, color, or creed. You were successful in spreading the holy name to every town and village. Your Vedic teachings will be the foundation age after age. You are the most perfect preacher. With logic and shastra, you would defeat the dissenter. You, Srila Prabhupada, are an ocean of compassion. You saw everyone equally with your spiritual vision. You are as merciful as Lord Nityananda, as filled with devotion as Lord Chaitanya. You have saved our fallen souls, otherwise we would be under Maya's control. You have given us the absolute truth. You dispel the concoctions of our wayward youth. With false conceptions, we are being misled. You clearly identify and define the path and the Supreme Personality of Godhead. You engaged everyone in the service of Krishna based on their ability. All that we needed was some sincerity. You possess all Vaishnava qualities as described in the Nectar of Devotion by Rupa Goswami. You were constantly absorbed in Krishna consciousness. Your thoughts, actions, and words were replete with blissfulness. You taught us to understand that we are not the doer, that everything belongs to Lord Krishna. He is the owner. You asked us all to cooperate. On individual ego and pride, we must not fixate. You emphasize that one must be careful not to offend, for offenses to a Vaishnava result in ruining devotion to no end. You revealed to us Vrindavan Dhamma and Mayapur Dhamma, gave us a topmost philosophy in Srimad Bhagavatam. Srila Prabhupada, the meaning of life you have confined, 16 rounds and 4 principles you stressed to abide. From your instructions, we must not deviate. Spreading the knowledge through your books was your mandate. You revealed to us our true identity, using the logic that we are souls, not this body. Srila Prabhupada, to you we are forever indebted. To describe what you mean to us, billions of words would need to be said. Please continue to keep us under your shelter and protection. May we always remain in the Devotees Association. Please keep us forever in your service. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Divine Grace. Jai Shiva.
so thank you. Now we'll do offerings by Prabhupada disciples, their own personal offerings, and service to the gospel. And then one is goody. You can follow after that.
Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasaya Vidare. Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swamiti Namne. Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Prakarne. Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Vajradharasi Prakarne. My dear Srila Prabhupada, please accept my most humble obeisances in the dust of the lotus feet. All glories to you, Srila Prabhupada. As we celebrate the 50th anniversary of ISKCON, it must be recognized you gave us the greatest gift in the world. Last year, in 2015 in Boston, we all celebrated your arrival 50 years ago in the West. How fortunate for all of us in the Western world, by the order of Guru Maharaj, Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Maharaj sent you, and you were so compassionate to take this troublesome journey. First and foremost, I would like to thank you again and again for accepting me into your lotus feet. In spite of that, I took a birth in a Vaishnava family and met many saintly persons who used to come to my childhood home. I did not get closer to Krishna consciousness until I met Krishna. I do not know anyone who is more closer to Gaudiya and Radha Krishna than you, Srila Prabhupada. You are the most merciful Guru in this universe. You have more qualities than I have pens, paper, mouth, brain, or anything like that. It will take me so many lifetimes to describe your glories. However, I will try few. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, Madhya Lila, chapter 22, 78 to 80, there are 26 qualities of the devotees are described. And in Srimad Bhagavatam, there are 30 qualities, and also there are qualities mentioned in Bhagavad Gita. But Srila Prabhupada, you surpass all of that. Let's look at few of the qualities, depending on the time I have for this offering. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, merciful. As far as I know, there is no one more merciful than you, Srila Prabhupada. A Vaishnava is merciful because he is a well-wisher of the whole world. And we know every time when you wrote the letter to us, you sign your ever well-wisher. It shows how merciful you are. And you are equal to everyone. You have given Krishna consciousness to each and everyone without caste, creed, and the race. And Srila Prabhupada, you gave the welfare work for everyone. The best example was given by His Holiness Vishwashtirtha in Sri Krishna Mandir Upadhi. He wrote for Prabhupada, he said, Ganga, Vyasa Ganga, every day in the Prema Sabri we say Ganga Bhai Ki Jai. But Ganga, when it comes down in India, by Bhagirath Maharaj, brought the Ganga, and it also called Bhagirathi. And but Ganga is only beneficial in people who go and take a bath in India. But His Holiness Vishwashtirtha said that Srila Prabhupada brought the Ganga of Harinam, which is ready to take the whole world back home to God. And Srila Prabhupada, you have all these qualities and more. Please be merciful to this menial servant so I can get even a little shadow of these qualities and follow in a minute way. Please keep me close to your lotus feet and service of ISKCON. Thank you, Srila Prabhupada, for real matchless gifts. You are worthless servants of our last class.
Yeah.
Thank you. Another Siddhi.
Dear Srila Prabhupada, my Vyasa's offering at the divine lotus feet of my spiritual master, His Divine Grace, Srila Prabhupada, my most humble obeisances at your lotus feet. No words to glorify you, my initiating guru, that you accepted me and your disciple that uttered to my name with your lotus mouth. Sometimes I feel wondered to, in trillions of lifetime, to have you, my initiating guru, my guide. You are my Lord, you are my master, you are my father and soul. I just want to I just want to serve you. Your mercy on me is unmeasurable. That you allow me to have your darshan every day. And I feel your presence in this temple. This temple is spiritually growing because of your presence, with your guidance, your instructions. Second and third generation, serving timelessly, their dedication is amazing. This year, 2016, is a special year for us to celebrate your golden jubilee. Already 50 years have gone by, and your ISKCON is growing, and your great grandchildren have doing wonderful service to serve your mission, Harinam Sankirtan. One distribution, these are the two pillars of this company. I just want this, my 45 years, this year, my 45 years is this ISKCON. It remind me, these days remind me of olden time, 1971-72, when the devotees were so dedicated, they were so much doing so much seva for the book distribution, Harinam Sankirtan. And the same thing I see now, our youth is always Girija time, and we used to get a van and fill your books and all the devotees used to go every day by Nam Sankirtan. Same thing I see now, our youth is doing so wonderful, amazing job. I'm here in the evening morning and I see they are all running like it. They are giving all their energy for temple, and this temple is really. Prabhupada is present here. Two holy dhams, Vrindavan and Mayapur dham, descended with you, your Raya Prabhupada. At the end, my sincere and gratitude to you for all the opportunities you gave me to serve you. You blessed me with a family of devotees.
You pointed out that a knife is neither good nor bad. A knife used to cut someone's throat is bad. A knife used to cut vegetables for Krishna's prasadam is good. Similarly, money used for sense gratification is bad. However, money used to print transcendental literature, build temples, buy flowers for the deities, and so on, is good and transcendental. We ask ourselves, how can I please Lord Krishna and my spiritual master? Aham Brahmasmi, I am spirit soul. Jivar Swarupayam Nityada Krishna Das. I am the eternal servant of Lord Krishna. Our duty, our dharma, is to ask ourselves, is this pleasing to Lord Krishna and my spiritual master? This is our compass. You inspire us to follow and assist you in fulfilling your spiritual master's order to spread Krishna consciousness to the Western world. You opened our eyes with the torchlight of transcendental knowledge. You connected us to Lord Krishna. He is in our hearts. He is waiting for us to turn to Him. He is like the sun. Krishna Surya Sama, Maya Vaya Andhakara. Maya is darkness. Wherever there is the sunshine, there is no place for darkness. Always remember Krishna and never forget Krishna. Stay connected by hearing, chanting, remembering, worshiping, and fully surrendering to Lord Krishna. You taught us by your personal example how to always remain in Lord Krishna's sunshine. You planted the seed of devotional service in our hearts, the bhakti. You nurture our devotional creeper daily with Srimad Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita, morning walks, wonderful instructions, personal letters, Krishna prasadam, preaching activities, book distribution, deity worship, chanting japa, and countless other devotional activities. Thank you, Srila Prabhupada. Preaching was always your focus because that was what your spiritual master Srila Bhaktisiddhanta expected of you. Krishna empowered you to spread Krishna consciousness outside India. And instead, you prayed to become his instrument, his puppet. You pointed out to us that we too could become empowered instruments. Your selfless devotional service attracted me to you. I had met someone worthy of my worship, someone who could guide me out of this material world of illusion and confusion. Srila Prabhupada, please help me remember my insignificant identity. Please continue to give me the association of your devotees and the shelter of your lotus feet. I know that I am not worthy of either. Though I will continue to serve you and your devoted followers, so that one day you will be proud to say, here is my disciple. Your insignificant and unworthy servant.
You showed us the path to our dear home. Seeing your austerity, purity and sincerity, Krishna came to support you with his full forces. Your desires came true and Krishna consciousness spread all over the world. Your Janman Guru, Jagat Guru, the great Mahatma, who did a wonder in the world, a miracle on this earth. It has been 15 years since you established ISKCON. With determination and boldness, you incorporated this society, putting Krishna front and center. From the humble beginnings of temples, spare parts, and matchless gifts, you successfully established hundreds of centers around the world, including temples, restaurants, farm communities. Now Krishna consciousness has even penetrated China and Pakistan. You have changed the lives of many, many people. Your movement is growing and growing, more and more. This ISKCON movement has additional devotees, and your books are known all over the world. Until the moon, sun, and stars remain in the sky, your glories will remain Srila Prabhupada. Jai Srila Prabhupada. Jai Srila Prabhupada. Jai Srila Prabhupada. Your wonderless servant, Prashant.
Jai!
Srila Prabhupada ki. And our Dharma Pranamuru will be speaking, and it looks like Bhakti Yoga is obvious. He's going to speak on his behalf. Let's hear from Dharma Pranamuru. Let's hear for all the devotees who are offering us.
Dear Prabhupada, Namo Vishnupadaya Krishna Krishnaya Vidhale Srimati Bhakti Vinatana Swami Dhinami Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharani Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paskartadi Shukavadi. I love you very much. I cannot say it directly with my strokes. However, I'm still able to distribute scent, clean charnamrita table, and give charnamrita in the morning, as there are less devotees in the temple. Now I'm also bringing Tulsi Maharani's black round tables during the morning program every day. Before, I was able to distribute books worth $200 every day at Chicago Airport, when my body was in a better condition. I was focused on being steady every day, but by Shishika Prabhu, I would distribute books worth at least $500 every day, and I couldn't compete with him. I love distributing books. Love you, Prabhupada, and I'm again going to Mayapur next year. Your servant, Prabhupada.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare.
We keep this family alive, and if we need more support to bring Krishna consciousness and this temple standing in good condition. His holiness, his divine ministry, His holiness, Sri Prabhupada. He has given us the role of great service and legacy to spread the Krishna consciousness, which the devotees are empowered by your grace, and to accept a disciple to help the world to go on Krishna consciousness. In the peace, harmony, and unity, every person of Krishna consciousness devotee is VIP in the world, who has a great part to establish the standard of living and religion. Krishna consciousness is great. Krishna is not an absolute landmark in the universe. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you very much. Srila Prabhupada ki. And now we're going to have a rep for our Toronto Sankirtan team. They're doing outstanding services by involving themselves in outreach. And the person who's the spokesperson is none other than also ISKCON's treasurer, His Grace Radha Mohan.
Dear Srila Prabhupada, please accept our most humble obeisances at your divine lotus feet that give shelter to so many souls. All glories to your compassion that has saved us all, and all glories to your mission, which guarantees our way to the lotus feet of your sweet Lord. Srila Prabhupada, you have instructed that every respectable person should have a set of Srimad Bhagavatam and Chaitanya Charitamrita in their homes. Taking this instruction and the desire of your dear disciples, His Holiness Bhakti Mark Swami and His Grace Vaisheshika Prabhu, to heart, the Toronto Sankirtan team is trying to push a new wave on of bringing the precious jewels of your transcendental purpose in the homes of people across GTA. For your Divine Appearance Day celebrations, the Toronto Sankirtan team had set a goal of distributing at least 50 sets of Srimad Bhagavatam in the last 30 days leading up to today. Starting from distributing a few small books on the street several years ago, to distributing full sets to the homes of unknown strangers, knocking their doors and begging them to bring Krishna in, to mundane scholarship, it seems impossible and over-ambitious. But time and time again, you have proven that impossible is a word in the fool's dictionary, especially when devotees get together to pour their heart and soul with one goal, to please you. And here in Toronto, Srila Prabhupada, by your mercy and the hard work of many, many devotees, the magic is beginning to unfold. Srimad Bhagavatam and Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita are entering people's homes, transforming their hearts and burning off their karma. By the intervention of fearless and innovative warriors, so many people are being introduced to the magical world of Srimad Bhagavatam and pushing forth their journey to the land of eternal happiness. For your pleasure and the pleasure of all your followers, the final scores for this set marathon are, we distributed 50 Srimad Bhagavatam sets and 5 sets of Chaitanya Charitamrita. For your pleasure.
Yeah. Thank you.
As well as we have 17 more pledges by devotees who would like to convert these pledges into actual Bhagavatam sets in the next few days. Like a little child trying to learn how to walk, we have begun to take baby steps. And like a loving father, Srila Prabhupada, you are encouraging us and protecting us from falling. It's your desire that these precious books find homes in every respectable household. So naturally, the Supreme Lord is obliged to fulfill your desire. And whoever takes part in this yajna, by your mercy, gets the credit. Please bless us that we continue to work together to please you, and that we always remain grateful for the opportunity to be associated with your Sankirtan movement. As we all work inwards to purify ourselves and get rid of all unwanted desires that plague our hearts, please bless us that we may remain ever hungry to find newer ways to bring your mercy in the lives of people around us, because your mercy is magic. All glories to you, your humble servant, Shamani Devadasi, Radha Mohan Das, on behalf of Toronto Sankirtan team.
Thank you very much.
And now we'll have a representative, or representatives plural, for the Rath Yatra committee. I have written down here Tarabali, Puja, Anjali, and Bhagyashri. Hare Krishna. Tarabali, here they are. What a wonderful Rath Yatra was this year. The best ever.
we bring hands together, perhaps? Hare Krishna, one more time. Thank you, Hare Krishna, sorry.
Dear Srila Prabhupada, please accept our most humble obeisances of glorious deity. On the auspicious occasion of your Vyasa puja and in celebration of 50 triumphant years of the ongoing revolution that is ISKCON, we, the Toronto Advisory Committee, would like to extend a few words of gratitude and a yearnest prayer to you, Srila Prabhupada. This year, we celebrated the 44th annual Bhakti Yatra in Toronto, and when you see this mercy, Srila Prabhupada, it was one of the biggest, most well-received, and sincerely appreciated festivals that the devotees at Livermore Dam have put together. It will interest you in particular to know that this year's team consisted of a group of extremely talented and enthusiastic young devotees, ranging from high school students to university students and young professionals, each encouraging the other while taking continuous guidance of their seniors, as well as taking collaborative initiatives and considerable responsibility in making this Ratha Yatra festival successful. Every endeavor undertaken was ultimately led by your instruction, and with a simple prayer in our heart to develop the mood of serving harmoniously as a family. You continue to take care of us lovingly, Srila Prabhupada, that every impediment seems conquerable if dealt by using the gems of knowledge that you have so kindly left behind for us. Without your mercy, we are but lost souls on the boat with no oars in this material ocean. The entire Toronto Ratha Committee would like to fall humbly at your feet a million times over in gratitude for continually providing us with a sense of direction and protection in this bewildering material world and its seemingly endless anxieties. A purpose to serve selflessly with our hearts and souls, a lesson to learn and to share with those who yearn, and the strength to practice a genuine, sweet surrender when our ego wants to take control. Thank you for giving us hope, Srila Prabhupada. Thank you for showing us the light. Thank you for teaching us how to stay calm under pressure and greet each other with delight. You have planted the seeds in our hearts to embrace the position as the servant of the servant. We thank you, Srila Prabhupada, for letting us follow in your footsteps with zeal most fervent. We fold our hands in thee and beg for alms of your mercy today and every day that follows, and pray that you may continue to bless us with strength to sway in the sweet service mellows. The humble servants, the exponential to Ratha Chakrini, your Ramana.
Thank you very much. And now to represent the Govinda's team is Indrish. We're very happy to have inserted into our seva and the premises 243 on the road Govinda's, which distributes prasadam every day, at least 6 days a week. It is the Food for Life initiative, actually, and many nice people come. We're not necessarily here to worship, but they get Krishna prasadam and they leave with a favorable experience. Hare Krishna. Dear Srila Prabhupada, please accept our dandavats and dust of your lotus feet. We are forever indebted to you, and with your mercy, prasadam distribution is continuously happening 365 days a year at Nuramunadala. We're conducting this service via lunch and dinner prasadam at Govinda's from Monday to Saturday, and as a result, thousands of fortunate people have been able to get Krishna's mercy via prasadam. Once they're at your Toronto home, they often wander into the temple and get darshan of Shri Radha Gopinath. And some take their books, so they have begun their journey back home, back to Godhead. We're trying our best to follow your vani, and it always amazes us that you have provided full instructions for every aspect of Govinda's. In the early years of the movement, you wrote, regarding the idea of prasadam restaurant, I am advocating it since the very beginning.
If you can manage such prasadam eating place and a temple at one place, it will be super excellent. I shall personally assist you in this affair because I like this idea very much. Our chanting is medicine and our prasadam is a diet for curing material disease. We wrote that on October 18, 1968. This service is indeed super excellent, and we are filled with gratitude and love for the fact that you are personally assisting. We pray that you continue to serve you and improve our service through love and cooperation with each other. It is our hope that many thousands more enter your home to get this special Krishna mercy via prasadam, and that we can in some insignificant way do some service to your beloved ISKCON, which you formed 15 years ago. Your worthless servants, Kishori and Indraish, on behalf of the entire Govinda's team, which includes Prabhupada, Gayatri, Neela, Sarvarasa, David, Srikant, Chanakya, Subhadra, and all the wonderful cooks, including Kamala Kanta, Deva Prabhu, Navadip Leela, and all the wonderful cooks that do cooking for you every single day. Thank you, Srila Prabhu.
And now to represent the Vedic Roots Montessori Academy is Shama Mohini, preschool. This is a new initiative in the GTA, Greater Toronto Area. We actually have a bona fide, certified school. Yahoo!
Please accept our loving obeisances. All glories to your compassion and example, which is a shining torch in our lives. On the most auspicious occasion of your Vyasa Puja Day, our hearts full of gratitude, we submit our humble offerings at your lotus feet. Some years ago, there was a desire to have a school, a little garden where the precious souls can be nurtured and nourished with the roots of Krishna consciousness, to blossom into flourishing, shade-giving trees. Inspired by the work of your disciples and guided by your desire to instill Krishna consciousness in children at a young age, we moved forward, and last year, the Vedic Roots Montessori Academy was born. In the last 1 year, there have been several challenges, times of desperation, situations forcing us to quit. But in all those times, Srila Prabhupada, you sent gentle reminders of how there was a reason behind the struggles. Seeing these children, both from within the devotee community and outside, chant Hare Krishna, honor Prasad, and learn about our Vedic scriptures with such enthusiasm, and at the same time gain material skills and knowledge at par, if not exceeding that offered by contemporary schools, the heart smiles, and it makes all the struggles worthwhile. There is a long way to go, for we have just begun. At this point, we do not know what the future will be like. But whatever it will be, Srila Prabhupada, we hope that blessed by your mercy, we will be able to try our best to realize this vision. The vision to create a safe and loving environment for precious souls in child bodies, to become deeply rooted in the Vedic wisdom, armed with material knowledge to become independently thoughtful individuals leading our society and the world of tomorrow. In your service, Shama Mohini Devidasi, on behalf of the Vedic Roots Montessori
Academy. And now to represent our drama team, we don't really have a name other than, if you want to Google Walking Monk Dramas, so we can just call it the Walking Monk Community Theater. So Savya Sachin will speak on our behalf. We worked with him for 15 years plus. He's a great actor you saw yesterday. He was the evil Bali. Shalom Prabhupada.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
So this was a last minute thing for me to read and prepare. I just wanted to share with you, Srila Prabhupada, something that I had written for you personally, and I wanted to incorporate some of my appreciation for what you've given to us in terms of drama. Our most beloved Srila Prabhupada, please accept and invite respectful obeisances, all glories to your divine grace. Where do we begin? How can we ever show our complete gratitude? Why have you been so merciful to all of us? We can never truly comprehend these answers to these questions, and we can never fully reciprocate all that you have given us. We've been so blessed to have you and your legacy around us in so many ways, from your books, to your disciples, to your philosophy, to your establishments, and mostly to the imprints that you've left in society, right up until today. Hope for a better, God-conscious future seems possible when we think of you and achievable with your guidance. Our desire to go back home, back to God, has only been crafted by your mercy. Your courage, along with your passion to serve Lord Chaitanya and his mission, leaves an impression in so many ways and has taught us to be fearless as we pick up the armor of the holy name and use it to defend against illusory energy of the material world. Srila Prabhupada, I want to thank you. You know, I've had many of us that do the dramas of Mars, we've had the opportunity to have Shastra around us, to have very enlightened personalities that inspire us in so many ways, but through your dramas and through what you've given us, has given us the opportunity to not only learn about what you wanted to deliver to the world, but also be part of it. You know, I consider myself illiterate in many ways. You know, reading scripture can sometimes be like putting together a Rubik's Cube. But when we're given the opportunity to present a drama, not just here, but around the world, it allows us to be part of what you're trying to deliver. It allows the audiences to capture the stories and the ways that you try to make certain that they're able to comprehend it. And for that, we're forever grateful. We're so fortunate to have one of your dear devotees, Bhakti Mark Swami, be there to guide us and to really leave an impression on most of us to really pick up and do what we can to serve you through this way. Thank you so much for the Prabhupada. Thank you on behalf of all the members, not just in Canada, but around the world, that continue to actually go ahead and pursue these dramas and make certain that your stories and their ability to connect to Krishna is there. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Thank you very much.
Srila Prabhupada ki. And now to represent the Krishna Club, which has been active for a number of years in York University, and if there's other places, I'm not exactly aware, but we have Radha Bhakti. Hare Bol.
Srila Prabhupada, please accept our most humble obeisances at your divine lotus feet. All glories unto you on this most auspicious day. This year, 2016, will mark the beginning of our 10th year of existence at the Krishna Club at York University. Over the last 10 years, our highlights have included kirtan events, weekly talks with prasadam, guest speakers including many visiting sannyasis, weekly meditation sessions, many books distributed, a drum circle, harinams, outdoor yoga classes where everyone walked away with a book, and more. But we're fledgling, Srila Prabhupada, that we have really big dreams for what we'd like to do for you. One day, we hope to see a Krishna Club that looks like this. There are hundreds of regular attendees each week at our regular weekly meetings and at our drop-in meditation sessions. We are constantly looking for larger rooms. We run a Krishna Cafe in the student center where thousands of students will honor prasadam every day. It becomes the most popular restaurant at York University. We have sold out kirtan events that students prefer to go to over clubs. We'll hold them at night and only stop when the police tell us that we're being too loud. These events will look just like clubs, except everybody will be high on the Maha Mantra. There are sold out shows to dramas by Bhakti Mark Swami's troupe. Visiting sannyasis give the talk regularly, and there are events where there is barely even any standing room. We have a very multicultural, regular audience, many of whom take to the regular chanting of the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra and eventually become regular devotees of the ISKCON congregation. And so much more, Srila Prabhupada. You once said that the only thing a person has to do to receive the Father's inheritance is to stay alive. You said that this is all we have to do to receive the endless mercy of the Lord. Just stay alive in Krishna consciousness. This is our prayer. These dreams are real. Our dreams are big. Please help us keep Krishna Club alive, so that in the very near future, we will have so many more dedicated and regular students to help achieve this vision that we want so badly in order to please you. Please bless us so that we can keep the service going because it is filled with so much potential. Thank you so much. With love, your servant at the Krishna Club at York University.
Hare Krishna. Thank you very much. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. And now representing the temple in so many portfolios, guru mentorship, outreach, giving classes, doing puja, counseling, etc., etc. The list goes on. It is Rupa Dutta Prabhu. Hare Krishna.
Dear Srila Prabhupada, please accept our most humble obeisances. All glories to divine service, divine grace. Srila Prabhupada, just like every year, we are once again celebrating the auspicious occasion of your appearance day, one day after Janmashtami. It is certainly a joyous, but at the same time, sobering day, which gives us an opportunity to thank you for all that we owe you. But today, I am reminded of the Mother's Day in 1970. I had been in Canada only a few months and had never heard of this Mother's Day. My local Canadian friends explained to me that on this day, they celebrate their mothers by sending her a card, chocolate, and or flowers. When I asked them why only one day a year, no one provided a good answer. I told them that in India, we do not have a special day assigned for mothers, simply because every day of our life is a Mother's Day. We love, respect, obey, and honor our mothers every day. Similarly, Srila Prabhupada, we're trying to develop that mood where every day is Prabhupada Day, and we want to become qualified to love, obey, and respect you every day for the rest of our lives, simply by reading your books and following your instructions. We want to learn from your example of considering our Guru's instruction to be our life and soul. Srila Prabhupada, kindly bless us so we can successfully convert our sentiments into actions and practice it every day. You risk your life and went through so much pain and austerity in following your Guru's instructions to preach in the West. You exceeded his expectations by spreading the holy name in all nooks and corners of the world, and thus made true Lord Chaitanya's prophecy that one day his name will be chanted everywhere. You had the conviction, you had the stamina and the willpower to overcome all obstacles in the path of your service to Guru and Gauranga. Srila Prabhupada, we are begging you for just a small fraction of that same fighting spirit and desire to serve you and our parampara. Please bless us so we may understand your wonderful purpose and act accordingly. And it is in that spirit, Srila Prabhupada, you have started an initiative in ISKCON Toronto called Mentorship. The main reason and purpose for the mentorship program is to provide that loving and trusting environment to all the devotees of ISKCON Toronto, ISKCON GTA actually, whereby they can have someone they trust, they can go to for spiritual, material, or any kind of questions or issues or guidance, and feel absolutely sure in their heart that the advice and the guidance that they will receive is for their benefit with no other motive behind it. Srila Prabhupada, we know, we realize how difficult it is for us to make progress in the path of devotional service. We know that we need help at every step. So this initiative is a very small effort in your service, Srila Prabhupada, to provide that help so that we all may progress in the path of devotional service to the guidance of senior devotees. This program is already in place. Anyone who's chanting 4 rounds or more is welcome to join us. There's a list of mentors that's on the blog, Toronto, ISKCON Toronto blog. Anyone is welcome to contact any of those mentors, actually interview them, and find out if there's a match of intent, match of thought process, and match of heart and mind. And by accepting one of these mentors, they can guarantee themselves of someone who cares, someone who will take care of their spiritual and material needs, and someone who will help them along the path. Srila Prabhupada, we are begging you for the success of this program. We are convinced that this will help us all in making the progress and get to the point where you are trying, or you have tried so hard to take us. Thank you, Srila Prabhupada. Hare Krishna.
Thank you so much for coming to Hare Krishna. So now we're just asking Kevala Bhakti, who represents our management team, to present to Srila Prabhupada formally the ISKCON Toronto Vyasa Puja book, which is a compilation of writings and offerings from the heart from devotees of Nuri Munadai. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
And he'll offer, and we'll get a chance to clap or Hare Bol or whatever, and then he'll say a few words. Okay? So Hare Bol and Hare Bol. So while that's being executed, as yesterday